Grace Lwanga channel for free meteorology and navigation instruments lessons. Grace Lwanga, for those watching for the first time, my name is Grace Lwanga and my profile has already been given in lesson 1 presentation. As a reminder, in lesson 1, we were looking at convergence and departure, a subtopic of instruments topic. Health rate. I am delighted, therefore, to discuss with you today another topic from the same subtopic. Our topic today is called earth rate. By earth rate, I don't mean the length of a day, but I refer to errors affecting the DJI during an airplane flight.
Here are gimballing error, real wander, which is sometimes referred to as random wander, earth rate, errors caused by the effect of incorrect rotor speed on the latitude nut. We shall explain what the latitude nut is shortly. And transport wander.
Introduction. Earth rate is one of the most fascinating sub-menu in gyro drift item because it makes you skilled in solving drift rates and hemispherical latitude notations. And of course, if you know hemispherical latitude notations, you can also compute total gyro drift rate. Therefore, I believe that this lesson 2 will benefit us all. Objectives of the lesson. By the end of the lesson 2, the viewer should be competent in the following terminology: definition of F parameter, definition of apparent wander rate, definition of earth rate, definition of hemispherical latitudes, write an expression for the F parameter, write an expression for the latitude nut compensation, write an expression for the constant apparent wander rate. Terminology details. First of all, it is very important to keep empirical sign rules when defining earth rate. 1. Earth rate is denoted by the symbol F. The equation for the earth rate is F is equal to 15 sine phi, or F is equal to F naught plus beta y. In meteorology, F is called the Coriolis parameter. The phi represents degree latitude. The F naught represents the initial earth rate of the DJI. The beta represents the latitude nut adjuster.
In the satellite footage, this hurricane is spinning counterclockwise in northern hemisphere, while the hurricanes in the southern hemisphere spins in clockwise direction. Why do hurricanes spin differently in different locations of the earth? And more important is that, why they spin? If you look at the rotation of the Earth from the North Pole, the Earth is seen counterclockwise spin motion.
In its simplest form, the latitude nut is an actual nut wound onto a thread on the spin axle of the gyro rotor, which we can see here.
Terminology details. First of all, it is very important to keep empirical sign rules when defining a thread. 1. Apparent wonder rate is equal to minus bracket transport rate plus earth rate bracket. Apparent wonder rate is the DJ drift rate due to transport rate and earth rate. 2. Latitude nut compensation is equal to minus 15 sin phi. The minus sign symbolizes compensation.
Although earth rate and transport wonder occur at the same time, when we come to do calculations, we calculate the error for transport wonder separately and add or subtract it to the equation for total wonder. At the equator, the latitude nut is central on the thread, as no induced wonder is required. As latitude increases north of the equator, the latitude nut is wound out to cause real wonder equal and opposite to the apparent wonder caused by the Earth's rotation. And south of the equator, the latitude nut is wound in to cause real wonder equal and opposite to the apparent wonder caused by the Earth's rotation.
Terminology details. First of all, it is very important to keep empirical sign rules when defining earth rate. 4. Northern hemispheric latitudes are by rule denoted by plus sign. 5. Southern hemispheric latitudes are by rule denoted by minus sign.
Earth rate equals 15 degrees times the sine of the latitude in degrees per hour.
When an object moves in the northern hemisphere, it deflects from its actual path to the right. Due to this effect, wind in this hemisphere formed a spinning cyclone, which is called hurricane, which is spin counterclockwise in the northern hemisphere. But in southern hemisphere, the direction of the spin of hurricane is opposite, because if the rotation of Earth is seen from South Pole, then it is looked in clockwise direction, because of which the object in this hemisphere is deflected from its actual path to the left, and the hurricane formed in this hemisphere keeps spinning clockwise. This is the reason the direction of the spin of hurricane is different in
earth rate applications. Now, what are the areas that you can be tested under the lesson objectives? Okay, one of the areas is when a flight goes along constant latitude, the earth rate remains constant during the flight. The apparent wonder rate does not remain constant during the flight.
Although earth rate and transport wonder occur at the same time, when we come to do calculations, we calculate the error for transport wonder separately and add or subtract it to the equation for total wonder.
Earth rate applications. Now, what are the areas that can be tested under the lesson objectives? Okay, another one of the areas is when a flight goes along constant longitude. The earth rate increases from zero at the equator to 15 degrees per hour at the poles. Earth rate applications. Now, what are the areas that can be tested under the lesson objectives? Okay, the other area is compensation change. Compensation is zero when the latitude nut is in the middle of the screw bolt. The compensation increases when the nut is screwed outwards and decreases when the nut is screwed inwards.
At the equator, The latitude nut is central on the thread, as no induced wonder is required. As latitude increases north of the equator, the latitude nut is wound out to cause real wonder equal and opposite to the apparent wonder caused by the Earth's rotation. And south of the equator, the latitude nut is wound in to cause real wonder equal and opposite to the apparent wonder caused by the Earth's rotation.
Earth-related applications. Now, what are the areas that can be tested under the lesson objectives? Okay, the next area is total drift rate. When the total drift rate is zero, then the DJ readings would be perfect. This is known as gyroscopic rigidity. When the total drift rate is above zero, then the DJI readings will be increasing and vice versa.
We can better appreciate this effect with this other example. Here, as we can see, independently of the movement of the frame or the gimbals, the rotor maintains its axis of rotation rigid in space.
Earth-related applications. Now, what are the areas that can be tested under the lesson objectives? Okay, the last but not least important area of the lesson objectives is the transport wonder rate of the DJI. There is no transport wonder rate when the airplane is stationary. However, the full length of this transport wonder rate sub-item will be given in another lesson.
Apparent wonder due to transport wonder will occur at the same time as Earth rate. In the case of transport wonder, however, the additional factor is that the gyro itself is moved across the Earth. Although Earth rate and transport wonder occur at the same time, when we come to do calculations, we calculate the error for transport wonder separately and add or subtract it to the equation for total wonder. We will look at this in more detail in the companion lesson on drift rate calculations.
A problem solution. The following CPL question was set by CAA and is available in the book Meteorology for Airplane Navigation Instruments by Grace Langer. A problem solution. A direct gyro in an aircraft is corrected to give zero drift when the aircraft is stationary on the ground in latitude 50 degrees south. Assuming the gyro to be free from random wonder, what drift rates may be expected when A, the aircraft is stationary on the ground in 32 degrees south, B, tracking east along the parallel of 40 degrees south at a ground speed of 540 knots. State whether the readings will be increasing or decreasing. Time. Viewers, because of time, you may have the solution to this problem in another session. Many thanks to all of you who have shared your video and sound clips with me in order to make the lesson a success. Meanwhile, those who can't find the book, you can send me an email or SMS and I shall send you the link. I'm always available 24/7. Please subscribe and benefit more from our channel. As I look forward to meeting you, I beg to stop here. Thank you very much for watching me and God bless you.